Hello friends, in this tutorial we are going to study how to design a binary search tree from given pre-order traversal sequence. It means that they have given us only one traversal sequence, that is pre-order traversal sequence in the question. This type of question may be asked in the examination for 10 marks. A question may be asked like this: construct a binary search tree from given pre-order traversal sequence, and a traversal sequence is given to you. Then another question is, what would be the in-order traversal sequence of it? We have to also find the in-order traversal of this binary search tree, and also we have to find the post-order traversal of it for 10 marks. Now there is a property of binary search tree, that is, whenever you traverse a binary search tree in in-order fashion, you always get the ascending order sequence of it. Okay, so we can easily obtain the in-order traversal for this binary search tree by arranging the whole data given to us in ascending order. So first I'll write here the given data, that is pre-order. That is 8, 3, 1, 6, 4, then 7, then 10, 14, and 13. To get the in-order traversal sequence for this given data, we just have to arrange this whole data into ascending order, because the design of trees is a binary search tree. In binary search tree, whenever you traverse any binary search tree in order fashion, you always get the ascending order sequence of the given data. So you just have to arrange this whole data into ascending order. So we'll get here 1 first in ascending order, then 3, then 4, then 6, 7, 8, 10, 13, and 14, last number. Okay. Now we have both the sequences in our hand. It is very easy for us to design a binary search tree from given two traversal sequences. Pre-order is also available now, in-order is also available. You can refer my previous video, how to design a binary search tree from pre-order and in-order, to better understand this type of designing. Okay. So I'll explain you how to design a binary search tree from these two sequences now. Our first job is to find the root node of this tree. As we know, in pre-order sequence, the root node always comes at the beginning. So we can easily say that from pre-order sequence, 8 is the root node of this tree. So we'll draw it here. 8 is the root node of the tree. It's a root node. And then to find the left child and right child of the root node, we are going to refer the in-order traversal sequence. In in-order traversal sequence, just go and check where is the root node appears. It appears here. Right. The part which appears on the right hand side of the root node, it is called right subtree. Whereas the part which appears on the left hand side of the root node is called as left subtree. After finding the root node of this tree, our next job is to find the left child and the right child of the root node. So I'll write it here. I'll put all this data on the left subtree. 1, 3, 4, and 6 and 7. On the left hand side, whereas on the right hand side we have 10, 13 and 14. Now it is a repeated recursive algorithm. We are going to apply all these steps recursively till the last element gets considered. It means that in the third step, again we need to find the next root after root node 8. The next root, whenever you find the next root, you have to go from left to right in pre-order sequence. So when you go from left to right, the next root is 3. Check into the diagram. Where is 3? 3 is here. If we make 3 as the root node, 1 is appearing on the left hand side, so it goes into the left subtree, whereas 4, 6, 7, which appears on the right side, will go into the right part of root node 3. So we'll draw here 8, 10. Now we are making 3 as the root node, so 1 will go to the left child and 4, 6, 7 goes into the right node. Remaining data is as it is, so we'll keep 10, 13, 14 here as it is. Now we place 3 successfully here. After placing 3 to its proper place, we'll go and check into the pre-order sequence, which is the next root. After 3, the next root is 1. We'll check it into the diagram. 1 is already placed because it is having only one value into this node, right? So there are no further values here and for left and right side. It is already placed. We'll go again into pre-order sequence to pick the next root. Next root is 6. Now check it into this diagram. Where is 6? 6 appears here. If we match 6 as the root node, what will happen? 4, which appears on the left hand side, will go to the left subtree, whereas 7 will go to the right side because it is appearing on the right hand side. We'll draw it. 8 is the root node, 3 left child, then to the left we have 1, to the right of 3 we have 6 now as the root node, to the left of 6 4 will go and 7 to the right. Okay, so 4 will be placed to the left child, whereas 7 will be placed to the right side. So 4 is left child, whereas 7 is left child of root node 6, and the remaining data as it is here, that is 10, 13 and 14. So we have placed now 6 successfully into the diagram. We'll again check into the pre-order sequence. Into the pre-order sequence, after placing 6, which is the next root? Next root is 4. Now if you see into the diagram, 4 is already placed because it is having single value. Then again go and check into the pre-order sequence. The after 4, 7 is the next root. We'll check into the diagram. Where is 7? 7 is here, and which is having only single value, it is already placed. So go to check and next value after 7. Next root is 10. Now go and check into the diagram. Here we have 10, right? 10 does not have any left child, but it has only a right element. So 13 and 14 will go to the right side of 10. We'll draw it. So here it is 8 as the root node, 3 left child, then 1 to the left, 6 here, 4 as it is, 7 as it is here. Now we are making 10 as the root node. When we make 10 as the root node, 13 and 14 goes to the right child because they are appearing on the right side. So 13 and 14 goes to the right side. We'll again go and check into the given traversal sequence. After 10, 14 is the root node. So we'll check it into the diagram. After 10, 14 is the next root node. So if we make 14 as the root node, what will happen? 13, which is appearing on the left hand side, will go into the left subtree. We'll draw that. Ten year, We are making 14 as the root node now. So 13 will go to the left side tree because it is happening on the left hand side. Here is 13. So if you see, all the elements from the given data has been covered. It means this problem comes to an end, and this is our final binary search tree. This is our final binary search tree. Now, to check whether the final binary search tree designed by you is correct or not, we'll traverse this tree in pre-order and in-order fashion. And if you get these sequences, if you get these sequences, then you can say that the tree designed by you is correct. Otherwise, there is certain mistakes. After designing the binary search tree, our job is to find the post order sequence for this binary search tree. So I'll write here post order. In post order traversal sequence, we refer the algorithm as we visit left subtree, we visit right subtree, and at last we visit root node. So L is left subtree, R is right subtree, and then at last we visit the root node V. V is the root node. So it is a recursive algorithm. We'll apply here and we'll design the post order traversal sequence for this diagram. If you want to learn about post order traversal sequence, you can refer my previous videos, how to traverse any tree in post order. Now for this diagram, the left post order traversal sequence is left is 1, then we will go to the right side of this node. So 4 is the next element, left, right, and then root, 4, 7, 6. We completed left subtree, we completed right subtree, and then last class we visit root node 3. So 3 will be visited after node 6. After visiting 3, the next node to be visited will be 13, because this is the left part we have done for root node 8. We'll go to the right part, so we have 13. Then there is no right subtree here, so directly 14. After 13 there is 14. After 14 we'll visit 10, and at last we'll visit the root node of this tree, that is 8. So this is the post order traversal sequence for this binary search tree.